Hello everyone. Now you can create a professional portrait using just three of your own photos. And of course, the most exciting part is absolutely free and quite simple. You can do it literally in several clicks. You can even draw inspiration from poses in other photos to create unique shots. And the best part of this is that all of that can be done without creating LoRa models, without using control net and stable diffusion, in traditional understanding of this. All of that is possible thanks for the Facechain project, the code of which has recently been published on GitHub. To use Facechain, you need to open Google Colab Notebook, available via the link below on my Patreon page. It's available for free. But if you subscribe, you will also gain access to other notebooks with Stable Diffusion, Dragon, and similar instruments, which I created specifically for you. Of course, you already understand what will be in this video. But I ask you to watch this video until the end, because I will also show you how to upscale your photos and how to save your trained Facechain model to Stable Diffusion. By doing so, you are also supporting my channel and this video. So very thank you for that. Very thank you. Very big thank you for that. Okay, let's go. Already, as usual, open Google Colab Notebook via link, which I'll leave in the description under this video. All you need to do, just press one button here and press start. That's it. If you have CUDA error, check your runtime here. Change runtime. Your runtime should be with accelerator T4 GPU. Now we need to wait a little bit.
1 minute later.
We've got our link here. Follow this link. Gradio interface is loading. And here we go, we are in a Facechain interface. Facechain interface consists of three tabs. Inference, where you can specify your prompt and generate your images. In Paint, where you can impaint your face in preloaded images. And Train. All needed information is specified here. First step, upload your photos, 3 up to 10 photos, headshot photos, and then click Train and select Switch tab to generate your images. That's it. Let's upload our photos. I decided to take 3 of them. Let's take this one and this one. You can also try ensemble training and LoRa enhancement. I tried to test it out, but it takes a bit more time to wait, so I decided to train without them. And finally, let's start training process by pressing this button. It takes about 20 minutes, and you can also check training process in a command line here.
1 minute 37 seconds later.
Here we go, we just finished our training and model is ready, as you can see here. Training done. Let's switch to inference tab. Here we can choose our style. Let's try default one. You can also try Chinese traditional costume. Also close style. I would like to use working suit. Well, there are also several options like armor, t-shirt and etc. And in advanced settings, you can specify prompt and two parameters, multiplier style and multiplier human. I don't know what does that mean, to be honest, but you can experiment with that. Now we should specify number of photos. Let's generate 4 for now. And once again, we should wait a little bit. We just generated our images and look at this. It's not just me, it's cooler me. Marat, who sleeps well and for some reason does not exercise and also has quite long neck, but we can fix it. Also, as I can see, there is no too much noticeable artifacts, almost ideal, and we can easily upscale that photos. Let's change our style to t-shirt and change our prompt in order to make my shoulders, which is a bit more wider. Now he looks exactly like me. I do like it. So much better. Well, if you got a person who looks exactly like you, but isn't quite you, like in my case with shoulders and neck, just edit some of the details in the prompt and it will help you. You can also copy a pose from any images. For example, let's try copy pose from this image. Just look at this. It certainly doesn't look perfect, but we got these photos from just 3 shots and it seems with only 1 angle in profile. So it looks definitely great. What to do next? So the next step, we should upscale our images. There is a lot of way to upscale image. I even make a video about it, but it's a bit complicated. So we can easily do that using ClipDraw service by stability. And here in the tools, we can use image upscaler. Unfortunately, you can upscale only 2x. in a free version, but it's already not too bad. So let's upscale our image and let's take this one. Here we can upscale only in smooth mode. We just upscale our image and it looks not ideal, but much better. So let's download our image. Now we should add our image to Canva. I explain why. Just create a design. It's also a free instrument. And let's try custom size. Let it be 2000 by 2000. Choose composition of your photos because we also use outpainting for our photo. Let's try this one. And then we should open Adobe Firefly in order to fix our image and upscale it. We can use free version. Here you should choose generative fill, upload image, and let's choose our image here. Let's outpaint our image. Press generate in order to outpaint our image. Perfect. We can also here fix some artifacts. In my case, I don't like these hairs. It looks unnatural. So let's fix it. Perfect. That looks much better. So here you can fix your different artifacts on your images. But to my mind, it looks already nice. So let's download our image here. Here we go. And once again, upload our image to Canva. Perfect. By the way, there should be a very big annoying watermark on your image because Firefly is better because it's free instrument, but we used Canva and create very big blank spaces. So thanks for that, we are able to crop our image without watermark, essentially outsmarting Adobe and doing it absolutely legally, which I find is very cool. So how to save your model for using, for example, in Stable Diffusion? Quite easy. There is a cell which allows you to convert your model from .bin to .safetensor. In order to use it, you should stop first cell with a face chain and then run this cell. That's it. It converts your model to safetensors and then you should copy this file by follow to the path, which is temp, personalization LoRa, and your model will be here. You can experiment with the logo models in Stable Diffusion. In my case, it didn't work well. Stable Diffusion produced strange characters who were either very white or looked very Asian, and that was definitely not me. And that, by the way, was quite funny. I think this is because Stable Diffusion doesn't have a strong understanding of how I should look. But you can experiment and share what you achieve. The notebook with Stable Diffusion and Facechain will be available on my Patreon. I think we created a very good tutorial because we managed to get a professional shot using Facechain, upscale it by 2 times with free clip drop, and also with the help of free Adobe Firefly, we were able to utilize generative features essentially by outsmarting Adobe, which is quite a unique situation, as you understand. So I really hope that you enjoyed this tutorial, and let me know by pressing the like button and leaving a comment if you were so impressed that you decided to subscribe to my Patreon page. I would be only thrilled. So, all the best and goodbye.